gave your life to Christ, and because Christ has risen together with you, you will not go back to grave early. You have.
Thank you, Father. I want you to just put up your hands. Father, we thank you for this time. Thank you for this moment. We want you to bless God. Bless the world that is coming. Bless Him. Bless the world that is coming. Ask God to give you a special grace to access His presence this afternoon. I just want you to open your mouth and say that prayer. Father, Lord, I receive a special grace to access your word, access your presence in the name of Jesus. Let somebody open up and pray right now. Come on, let me hear you. Open your mouth and pray in the name of Jesus. Pray in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we give you the glory. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. Somebody wants to pray for Jesus. Please, may take your seat. May take your seat. Hallelujah. Somebody say, I am blessed. So without wasting much of my time, I'm still, you know, on the topic, pray that Lord. And that today, by the grace of God, just want to lead us in one or two prayers that will help us, you know, to enjoy the dividends of liberation and the deliverance. Hallelujah, amen from the Lord. Hallelujah. So what you don't know where it's coming from, what you don't know the root of it, it will be impossible for you to assess what is behind this. Amen. I remember a scripture that said, Jesus said to the disciples, go into the village over against you. He said, you shall find the donkey tied. And he said, lose the donkey and bring the donkey to me. In other words, go to the village. There's a particular village that I am sending you to. Now if you get to that village, you shall find a donkey, you shall find an animal that is tied there. He said, lose the donkey and bring the donkey to me. But if anyone asks you, why do you have to set the donkey free? But say to the person that the Lord is in need of that donkey. And the moment the person shall hear you declare that, he shall let you go. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ. May somebody receive the hand of deliverance. Receive the hand of liberation. Because somebody, something shall let you go in the name of Jesus. I said, something shall let you go in the name of Jesus. And something shall let you go in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. He said, you shall find a donkey. And I asked somebody a question one time. I said, there is a donkey actually that was tied there. And then do that donkey, who actually tied the donkey? And that is, if you can understand who tied the donkey, then you can trust who put the law. Amen. He said, who tied the donkey? That's a question. And then it's very simple to understand that a stranger cannot tie the donkey. It has to be the owner of the donkey to tie the donkey. You see, so the person that tied that donkey is the owner of the donkey. And then who is the owner? It could be the father, it could be the uncle, it could be the grandfather, but there's somebody around the person who is responsible for the tying of the donkey. And if you read the scripture very well, you understand that Jesus was not really talking about a donkey that was tied. It's a spiritual thing. And when Jesus finished his word, he said, lose them and bring them to me. Amen. And then there's a person said, if anybody asks you, say to the person that the Lord is in need of high, is in need of a donkey. Now, when you read the scripture, you come across where they were talking about her and then them. So when he was talking about her, he was talking about somebody that could be in the place of that donkey. He might be looking at somebody, he might be looking at a donkey, but behind the donkey there is a woman. Behind the donkey there is a boy. Behind the donkey there is an adult. Behind the donkey there is someone that the enemy has tied. When you look at the person, you see donkey. If you look at the person, you see donkey. The donkey there is a sign to show there is someone whose life has become like a life of a donkey. Now let me tell you something about donkey that you don't know. Donkey is that kind of animal that derive joy in labor. If you have seen donkey before, it's different from horse. So when the donkey must be agile to be happy, he must pack heavy load on that donkey. Amen. I don't need somebody to understand that. If a donkey must be happy, sir, they have to put enough load by the two sides, heavy one. So when the donkey struggle with that load, that is the joy. See why only tables. Amen. So there are some shouting people that their life has become like that of the donkey. Every day of their life is struggle. People have become, their lifestyle has become the lifestyle of a struggle. If you look down at the struggles, behind him there is a donkey. If you see the donkey at his side, behind that donkey, there is a man, there is a woman. Right, pray in the name of Jesus. Whosoever that life has turned, whosoever the enemy has turned his life or her life to the life of an animal, the life of a donkey, to subject you to a lifetime struggle, into a lifetime bondage, as your hands are lifted up to heaven, I declare your freedom in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare your liberation in the name of Jesus. I declare your liberation in the name of Jesus Christ. Jesus said, if anyone asks you, say to the person, I, the Lord, is in need of that donkey. The reason why your liberation shall be guaranteed is because God is interested in your case. The reason why your deliverance, your miracle, your healing, the reason why you shall come out of that case is because Jesus is interested in your case. God is interested in your case. I don't know somebody who is believing that God is interested in his case. If you can believe and know that God is interested in your case, you are coming out in the name of Jesus Christ. I say you are coming out in the name of Jesus. I say you are coming out in the name of Jesus. You are coming out in the name of Jesus. When God is interested in your case, then the assurance of your deliverance is established.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God is interested in somebody's case.
Amen.
If you are the one here, let me hear you shout the big amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So when you look at that donkey, you see, you trust who put the law. Amen.
Amen.
And then that donkey, the life of the donkey, is somebody, it's actually somebody that something, life or powers or laws or chance, there is a reason why somebody has been turned into a donkey. Now let me tell you something. I talked to them, it was the deliverance happens like this, you know, and the lady came out and she was saying something official. He said, anytime we go to do for money, he said, I am responsible of, you know, turning some certain of our people, their face, like the face of a monkey or animal, anything. That while we are looking for money, if anyone comes around, look at you, what he sees is an animal. What he sees is some image. He sees some certain thing that scares them. And the moment they approach these people, they see some certain things on their face. And they will run away from them and go for another. Somebody confess that I'm responsible. I have practiced that. I have done a lot of things to make sure that I cover the face of the people whom I am working together with. And then when some people come to them, they will not see a human being, but they see a different thing. And that's why many live in a particular country for many years. They say, what is happening to me? What is happening? Why is it that something is not happening? People are not coming. I don't see money. Somebody has torn your image. Somebody has torn your face. Somebody has done something that anytime they look at you, they are not seeing you. They are seeing another thing that the enemy has placed on you. But I pray in the name of Jesus Christ, whosoever is under that curse, as your amen is not, may God send fire on you at the point of that image the enemy has placed upon you. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that your original face shall come back to you. Whatever image, whatever masquerade that have placed on your face, many people don't see you and see different person. Anytime they come to me, it's another person that they see. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your face receive deliverance right now. Let your face receive deliverance right now. Let your face receive deliverance in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your face receive deliverance. Let your face somebody.
Amen. I know that lady. I know she's a very nice woman. She has a good heart. And the person heard about your story, he's interested. But anytime he tries to come to where you are, what they told him is not what he said. They said the lady is very fair and tall. But when you look at you, you see an ugly and short woman. Somebody turns you in the realm of the spirit. When your people, the people that want to help you, when your helpers find you, they will not see exactly the person. There's an little change of direction. There's a little change of direction and a change of stature. Somebody, you are fair in the physical. But when your helper comes, what he sees is a dark person. When your helper comes, what he sees is an ugly person. But when the person comes, he doesn't see what it is. Pride, he sees a different thing, because somebody has told your image, somebody has blessed you, where you need a garment, somebody has blessed a different thing and a negative nature upon you. That is why your people, the people that are supposed to help you, that's why they pass you by. Do you know how many people that would have helped you, but they pass because they don't recognize you? When they look at you, you are not the one that they gave you the description of. But I pray in the name of Jesus Christ, anyone that is under that curse right now, anyone that is under that curse right now, I release the fire of the Holy Ghost. I release the fire of deliverance. I release the fire of deliverance. I release the fire of deliverance. Let your original nature return back to you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, my Father. In the name of Jesus. Holy Brakatu Moshe. Hallelujah. Somebody say, blessed. In the name of Jesus. So when you look at that donkey lifestyle, you can trust who tied the donkey. And I tell you that the person that tied the donkey is not somebody far. It's the owner of the donkey that tied the donkey. Now, who is the owner? The owner is the caretaker. It's the person that says, I give birth to you. I brought you to this earth. I buy you. I gave you life. I made you who you are. Amen. But this person, many a times, they are not operating in their right senses. They are operating according to a law, a pattern of law that are placed in a particular family. Amen. And then I show us somewhere in the book of Zechariah last Sunday, and then when the Bible talk about the horn, and I told that horn is a sign to show that there is an ancestral activity going on in any particular family that sees that one. Now, if you are very close to symbols, and if you have one of your uncle that used to drive Mercedes that time, and if you look in the back of his car, you see some certain things that look like maybe coffin. You know, this day you see something like where they pick the hygienic paper, the one they used to clean hands, you know, that packet, so that they put it at the back. But then, you will see something like golden, like a coffin image, or has like a four-corner square shape, always at the back. So that thing is a sign, it's a symbol that this man belongs somewhere. Praise the Lord. And then you see some certain things that look like a horn. There was a lady that I told one day, why do you always like to buy any of these jewelries that has a dragon shape? Amen. All the jewelries. The one in the ear, nose, neck, everywhere are dragons. Why is it, Pastor? And I went to like, I didn't want to go for it. I knew that that's a symbol of something. You need to understand symbols. Symbols are signs. Praise the Lord. They are signs. Somebody said, one of my friends said to me, this thing that you put on your neck, now a sign of cross, Jesus Christ. Now he said, that is not our Jesus. No, Jesus has God. That's an image. That was so strong. I said, okay, fine. I put it on the cross. I put the cross on my neck and the image of Jesus. I said, which one is better? Is it the one they draw dragon or snake or fish? But when they draw something like Christ, which one is better among them? Amen. Would it be better I should go and take the one that they put a serpent on? Or the one they put dragon? Is it what you want me to put on? I will put on something that look like where I am going, or what I believe, or where I am worshiping. Praise the Lord. Is it what you want to say?
So anytime you see some certain things, you see that this thing is a symbol. And I told us last time here, I said, many times we see animals, just like some women, who are looking for the seed of the womb. Sometimes when they are conscious of that, I never get it. And they, when they feel that they are pregnant, and because they are under some certain attacks, you will see the person will say, I went to the market, and then when I went to the market, somebody took me to where they sell oil. And then when I stumbled at the oil, and then I was pricing the oil, the oil didn't break. And when I woke up in the morning, the baby, I was coming. And somebody said, I saw something like a red color, and in the morning, the baby is no more there. So all these things are signs to show that something wrong with this person, or there is something that's going to happen after I've seen those signs. Amen. Is anybody with me? So many times we see ourselves being pursued by some animals. See, the animal that pursues you in a dream determines what is wrong with you. If cow is pursuing you always in the dream, then know that you are under some ancestral forces, under some activities that are committed by the ancestors. Praise the Lord. Is anybody here with me? So the cow pursues you all the time. Pastor, they for this cow, they pursue me. Then your family need serious depression. Sometimes it's masquerade will chase you here and there. All these things are signs. Amen. Amen. But the sign I am picking this day is the sign of the ancestors. And remember, I told you last time that the ancestors are not demons. Ancestors are not bad spirits. Ancestors are the spirit of our late fathers, our late grandfathers. Amen. So when they die, they become an ancestor. Imagine the man who saw you through. Imagine the man who, when your father died, it was your grandfather who paid your school fees. It was your grandfather who stood for you and made sure that you went to university and graduated and become what you are today. He was a very nice man, an evangelist, a deacon in the church. You know that this man had a good heart. Many people contributed money into his hands, and when they came, you gave them their money. When they died, after about 10 years, you will carry Bible and carry a candle and come out in the night. I bind you, you spirit of my grandfather, me ancestral spirit. Now that is foolishness, because there is nobody you are going to buy, and God will not answer that kind of prayer. Because even you yourself, you know that this man was a good man. So the spirit of your grandfather is the spirit of our ancestors. That's our ancestor. So they are not demons. They are not demons. In fact, they can help you. Have you not heard that somebody said, I died, and while I was running to a particular place I didn't know, I saw my great grandmother. I saw my grandmother who appeared and said, go back, go back, go back. And all of a sudden I woke up. Have you not heard that story before? Now that woman is your ancestor. If it was a bad woman, why would we have brought you back to her? Praise the Lord. Can I hear you for somebody?
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. So, what we are talking about is the thing that they did before they died. Amen. Those are the things that are the works of the ancestors that are hurting us today that we need to deal with. Can I hear you from somebody?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, how the ancestral causes comes into our family. Number one, I want to share about two or three things here. How they come into our family. Amen. How they began to operate. Amen. Don't miss me here. I'm not talking about the ancestors. They are bad people. No. I'm talking about their activities. Those activities are called ancient wisdom. What did I call it? Ancient wisdom. Because in their time, it's a wisdom. In their time, it works for them. But what they didn't know is that they didn't know that things will change in the future when those things will no longer be relevant. Amen. Because of the change of things, most of those things there are disturbing us, hurting us, are making us to live a particular kind of life. So how did they come in? They came in by ancestral blood covenants. What did I call it? Ancestral blood covenant. Number one, how they come in is ancestral blood covenant. That means there are some certain things that they did at that time with the blood. Amen. Remember, then our ancestors, there is a law that said, If any child is born on a day, on a particular market day, they will kill the child. That's the law. Amen. You remember these people they call Afi. Some of you know those people they call Afi. You know Afi? Those guys that are so fair, sometimes they are in. But listen, there is no difference between you that think you have a good color and them. Everything in your body is what is in your body. But any family that gave birth to such color of a child that time, they will take the child and kill the child. Sometimes they throw them into a full forest. These things are the activities of the ancestors. I remember somebody that they give some certain time. Some of you read the Take Soul Apart. You read this Soul Apart? Amen. And you remember when that boy called Ikelofi? He said, the man said, this boy called me father. Ikelofi was an orphan that was picked up by this man and he trained him to become his son. But just because there is this custom of Uncle John that every year, somebody must provide a child for sacrifice. And this boy, it is done of this man to produce, but he wouldn't give his own children. But somebody said, you have somebody in your house that is not your child, he can be sacrificed. And the plot was set. The plan, everything was set. And then they chose the boy to catch the boy. But on his way running, he saw his father afar off. And then he ran to meet his father, that these men are chasing me, they want to kill him. So he opened his arms to impress his father for rescue. But the father brought out the sword and he moved his head. That was not just a novel, it was a story. But the real story was that there was this culture, there was this tradition that they performed every year. The real story of that takes for a part is that in a particular community, in a particular place, in a particular country or particular region, there is this culture that said that every year